Yes, good morning. Now we will start with the chapter statistics. The probability I have explained and introduction of probability I have given to you. That is few questions we have done. You go to the NCERT book, you will find variety of questions. So questions you can do yourself. Now the very important topic is statistics. In statistics we have to study about mean, median and mode for the group data. Now mean, median and mode for raw data we have studied in 9th class, and the introduction of the statistics that also we have studied in 9th class. But here to continue with that, and you have to find out mean, median and mode of all group data. When we talk about group data, we have two types of class interval, and that we have studied in 9th class, continuous class interval and discontinuous class interval. And you have also studied how to convert discontinuous class interval into continuous class interval in 9th class. But in the 10th class, you remember that we have to study mean, median and mode for group data only. That is very important. Now mean we have by three methods. Mean by three methods. First, direct method. Second, assuming method. And third, step deviation method. So in today's lecture we will be studying about mean, median and mode. So when we talk about mean, you always remember that the class interval should be continuous. This is very important. Now in this mean we have three methods. So we will be doing direct method. Not direct method. In direct method, mean or average, that is x bar equal to summation f x upon summation f. I used to write this x bar equal to summation f x upon sigma, that is summation is the total sum. And now the tabular form, what is needed? So first of all you must know where is f is frequency. Where is f is frequency? X is class marks or mid value. That is x, you will say upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. This is now what is needed. You can form in the tabular form also. That is class interval. This is the class interval. Now this you can say as f frequency. Now in the this is what sigma f total of this x and you will say upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. After this you will be making one more column, and that column is f into x, and the total will be summation f x equal to. So the class interval, all of you must be knowing, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50 and 50 to 60. kind of number 0 to 10. Between 0 to 10, how many numbers are there you can write? X, you can find out. I have X, this is fx. So f into x you have. Generally, we are using the direct method to find. But now, when we have to find out the direct method to find out mean, in exam it is not mentioned in the question you have to use by this method. But you must know all three methods, and after that you will be able to solve this. So mean, this is the method, direct method to find out the mean. Yes. Now variety of questions are there in this. If sometimes they say find mean of the following data is 7. Find the value of k. So k may be unknown frequency. Any unknown frequency you can take as k, and you can find out by this. So remember this. Sometimes it is said find the missing frequencies. Frequencies, that is plural form. The two unknown quantities are there, and you will say let first frequency as f1 and second unknown frequency as f2, and you will do the question. But in that f1 and f2 is unknown, you will say two equations will be formed to form solve the equation to get the value of f1 and f2. So that is very important. So here, after this, what you have to do now comes the after the direct method, we have a second method, that is assumed mean method. Second is assumed mean method. Now second, assumed mean method. Second, assumed mean method. Mean, assuming method. So x bar a plus sigma md upon sigma m. This is the formula to find out. So sigma md, but again we will be taking as capital M instead of small m. So capital M, once you remember what you are taking, try to write the same one, sigma m. Now, where A is assumed mean, this is needed in the 11th class, so please see that A is assumed mean, and in bracket you can write in column of X, A is where you will find, from where you will get A, in from the column of X, any value you can take A. Now f, you know, is frequency, d is deviation, and d is what? X minus a, and x is class marks or mid value, and x, you know, upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. But in case of this table, what you have to remember, that in case of table, what you will do, again the same thing is that class interval, frequency, x, that is A will be here, A, then B, X minus A, and F, B. So this is what you have to, that this is the table what you needed to answer. By answer the B. Now F, B, again here. This is sigma m, and here sigma m b. sigma f b. But here you will find negative, positive, negative, positive total, and you will get the small number. So this is another method to find out the mean. Mean, assuming method x bar equal to a plus sigma mt upon sigma f. This is the second method to find out the mean. The monthly test is coming, I think so. So you must be getting the information. First and second chapter we are taking. After this assuming method, we have third method, and that is the third method is shortcut method. Shortcut method, or you can say that step deviation method. Shortcut method or step deviation method. Now third method, step deviation method. You can say that as short cut method. Now in the exam only the question will be that find the mean. It will not mention by which method you have to solve. So it depends on you, but you have to apply, see the class interval. If class interval is say as 0 to 10, 10 to 20 and 20 to 30, and the value of f and x you can multiply easily, then use the direct method. But in case question is given like that, class interval is 400 to 450 and 450 to 500, and when you are multiplying by, you are getting x and multiply by f, it takes time, then you use the shortcut method to find out the mean. So again, mean x bar equal to a plus sigma f u upon sigma f into h, where again k you have studied, a is assumed mean, that is in column of x. F is frequency. U, that is you are calculating x minus a upon h, where h is class size. Now this class size equation you have studied in 9th class. Class size, you can say that difference between two consecutive class marks, or you can say that upper limit minus lower limit in case of continuous class interval, but you cannot take as in the discontinuous class interval. So here we have written this formula, and what you are seeing here, that you have to see. After that we have the table of how class interval you will be making, frequency you will be making. After that, x upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. That is, you can say that x upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. Now, after this, right a, here is sigma f u x minus a upon h, and then you write x u. Now sigma fu, fu. But here, where you are taking a, no need to put the values of x, a and x. Directly you can say that here is 0, minus 1, minus 2, and 1, 2. Try to take in the middle. A you can take here also. If you are taking a here, then it will be 0 here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and minus 4. Somebody says I will take a here. Yes, you can take a. So a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this is what you can take. After that, you take minus and you take as plus. So this is the way you can do the questions of mean by third method, step division method. And in step division method, you have to remember this. So variety of questions are there. Find the missing frequencies. My missing frequencies, then F1 and F2 is unknown. Two unknown quantities, that is F1 and F2, you have to calculate. So after this, now you sometime it is said mean is given, find the value of k. That is also that type of question you have to do. So the mean topic today is, we have done this mean, and tomorrow we will do the question of this chapter. So please, after that, yes, we will be doing the question tomorrow in the lecture 2.